Hey everybody, and welcome back to another episode of 13-Minute AE Tutorials, where you learn tips, tricks, and shortcuts in 13 minutes or less. No BS, just AE. This episode is an update to a tutorial I made about a year ago, where I showed you how to make a carousel for four media objects. As soon as I posted that tutorial, I immediately started getting questions about how to create a carousel for more than four media objects. At the time, I wasn't sure exactly how to answer that question because of the way I created it. A lot of times, I'll take expressions and custom create projects, so the point of that episode was to accommodate only four media objects. But I get the need for some flexibility, so after a lot of experimentation, I've cracked the code. So if you missed that first tutorial, don't worry. I'm going to cover everything you need to know in order to create this carousel. I'm also including a link to a shape layer social media icon pack that I created that you can use for free. Since these are shape layer animation presets, you can drop these right into your user presets and have immediate access to them. I'll also include some install instructions so that way you have no problem loading these up. This is just my way of saying thank you for watching my channel. Speaking of which, please like and share this episode so that way my channel can take advantage of that pesky YouTube algorithm. And don't forget to click the bell so that way you're notified every time I upload a new video. Okay, there's a lot to get through, so let's dive right in. Okay, so we just need to set up our project here. So I'm going to use some shortcut keys to do this. It's always good to have some shortcuts handy. Control-Alt-Y or Command-Option-Y. We'll add an adjustment layer. Just name this Controls. And then we need to add in some null objects. So Control-Alt-Shift-Y or Command-Option-Shift-Y will give us a null. Then Control or Command-D to duplicate that. So we have three null objects. Let's make all of these 3D. Okay, so let's rename these null objects. We'll call this one Camera Control. We'll call this one Camera Focus, and then we'll call this one Spinner. Control-Alt-Shift-C or Command-Option-Shift-C will give us a camera, and we'll just add that in. So let's take our camera control, move it above our camera, and just parent this camera to the camera control. So that way, this camera control will be what we use to control our camera settings. And I like to go ahead and just highlight both of these and make them the same color, so that way they're inseparable. Okay, so now the next thing we need to do is we need to add in some media pre-comps. I like to pre-comp these because it allows you to easily swap out media, either images or video or vectors. So Control-N or Command-N, and we're just going to call this Media 1. Okay, and then I want to make the size of this comp, we'll say 650 by 650, hit OK. So this is going to hold our first media. And let's go ahead and just add in a shape layer into this. I'm going to leave this alone for now and go back out to our main comp. Since we're doing a media carousel for multiple media objects, let's go ahead and duplicate this media 01. So Control or Command D, and it will just rename it for you 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So that way we have 8 of these. Just highlight all of these and double click, and that will open up all of your comps here. I've made a social media pack that I'm going to make downloadable to everybody. So that way you can have that and drop it into your user presets. This will show you how easy it is to use that social media pack. So under user presets, I'm going to navigate down to social media pack. And so you have these by name. So just with this layer highlighted, we can just double click these. So the first one, let's make that the apple. And then we want to make sure that we align this to the center. Media 2, highlight this shape layer. So we make this Dropbox, and again, we want to make sure this is centered. Media 3, we'll do Facebook, and align that. Media 4, set in Google Plus, and we can align that. Media 5, Instagram. Media 6, LinkedIn. Media 7, do Pinterest. And for Media 8, let's just do Skype. Okay, so this is all of our media right here. And if you click through, you can see that they're all in there. Let's go back out to our main media carousel comp. Let's go ahead and pull in this Media 1 here. We're going to make that 3D and hit P for position. You want to right click and separate dimensions. Or with position highlighted, you can also go up to animation, separate dimensions. So if you're using a laptop or a Mac mouse that may not have that right click, you can also go up to animation, separate dimensions. For each one of these medias, we're going to need a null object, and we're going to name it Media 1 Control. And we need to make that 3D. And we need to start linking some of this up. So just follow along with me, and I'll explain in a second exactly what we're doing. But Media 1 needs to be linked to Media 1 Controller. Media 1 Controller needs to be linked to our spinner. Then let's open up our controls right here. And then we need to add in some controls here. So let's go to effect, expression controls, and a slider control. Now let's duplicate that twice. So we have three slider controls. First one, let's name distance. Second one, let's name degree. And then this third one, we're going to name size. So now we need to start linking some of these properties to our controls here. Let's go ahead and lock down our effects control. Link our Z position up to distance. Open up our media one control and hit R for rotation. And we want to link our Y rotation to degree. And then media one S for scale. And we need to link our scale to this size right here. And notice how our icon went away. It's because our scale, as you can see, is set to zero because our slider for size is zero. So I'm going to just bring this up, put it back at 100. So after a lot of experimentation, I came across an expression that works perfectly for this carousel. She hit EE on our media carousel. Right now, this rotation is being linked to this degree value for our slider, which is set at zero right now. We need to add in times index. And what this does is it takes the value of our degree and it multiplies it by index. And the value of index is simply the value of the layer number that this script is located on. This media controller, as you can see, is layer one. Well, index is one. So this is saying take this degree amount, right now set to zero, multiply it times index or multiply it times one. And this is very important. It's actually the foundation of how this project is put together. So I just want you to understand what this times index means. Okay, so let's open up our spinner. If we hit R, and we can see, first of all, we need to move this distance out a little bit. So it moves away from our center. So maybe something like that. Now watch as we rotate, we can see it goes around, but it doesn't continue to face the camera. And we do want it to face the camera. So the way we do that, let's right click on our media one, go to transform, auto orient, and we want to orient towards camera. So now whenever we spin this around, it will always be facing the camera. So that's exactly what we want. And now let's start to add in some more of these media boxes. Highlight media one control and media one and control or command D to duplicate. And this part is very important. Your media controllers need to be in order for this to work. And the reason why is because of that index expression. And let's just change this to where it says media to control. So now what this expression is saying is we're going to take the Y rotation, use the value of degree and multiply it times index, which now is two because this is layer two. So this one takes that value zero, multiplies it by one. This takes that value, multiplies it by two. And the way this is going to work is you want to divide your degree, since the carousel is on a 360 degree radius, by the number of media boxes that you have. So we'll say 360 divided by two because we have two media boxes. So now if we rotate, we can see that they are equidistant apart. And let's go up top and check it out up top. As we rotate, we can see that's exactly what we want. They're on opposite sides of one another. So this index expression is really what's making this happen. And I'm going to stay up top and show you as we add in another media controller. So, and actually let's swap this out. So the way you replace comps or layers or anything, and you want to retain whatever's on that layer, such as expressions or keyframes, you highlight this media one right here, go to media two, and on the PC, alt drag. And as you'll see, it pops right on. So now media two is on this layer here. So let's highlight media two control, control or command D to duplicate. And again, you want to bring this underneath. So we're going to call this media three control. And then let's highlight this media right here and just pop in media three. So alt drag. And then we want to go back to our degree. And remember, we want to do the math, 360 divided by three. Now watch our comps. So now they're equal distance apart. And you can do this for as many media controls as you want. If we go back to our active camera and play with this, we can see that's exactly what we're going for. So again, this is using this expression, this index expression. So it's using this degree amount, multiplying it times index. So this is 120 times one. This is 120 times two, 120 times three. And that's how we're getting this to be in a perfect circle. We have eight media boxes, so let's go ahead and just make all eight of these. So if we highlight media three control, we're going to control D or command D to duplicate 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Okay, and then let's rename these. So we have bring media three right here. So now we're going to call this media four control. And I'm just going to copy this media four control text so I can paste it on the other media controls and just change the number. So media five control, media six control, media seven control, and media eight control. Okay, so now we need to replace the media containers so we have all eight of them in our timeline. So I'm going to alt drag media four, alt drag media five, Alt-Drag Media 6, Alt-Drag Media 7, and Alt-Drag Media 8. And then if we go back over to our degree, we have 8 media boxes, so we're going to go 360 divided by 8. And as we can see, everything lined up perfectly, exactly as we wanted it. This is where you may want to adjust your size slider, so maybe make this 75%. Maybe want to pull these out a little bit further. And so this rotation here is going to be what controls this carousel. Now, you have a few options with this rotation. You can either put like a time expression. So like if you just want to spin, do like time times 100, for example. And then if you watch that, it'll just rotate in that direction. If you type in time times negative 100, it's going to go in the opposite direction. Or maybe you want to control these where it stops on a certain media box. And the way you would do that is we'll just start at 0 and maybe go forward, we'll say like about a second. And say, what if you wanted it to land on media 3? Well, if you just kind of spin this around until you see it up front like that, animate this where it kind of comes in. Maybe you want to slow it down, use a, you know, like an easy ease keyframe where it eases in. And maybe you want to hold there. So maybe you want to go in the opposite direction and land on LinkedIn. So you have something kind of like this. It comes in and stops on Facebook, stops for a second, and goes a bit of LinkedIn. So you can use this spinner in one of two ways. Just for purposes of what we're doing, I'm just going to set the time expression on this. So I'm going to say time times 100. Okay, so as you can see, you can add as many media containers and media controllers as you'd like. The thing that you have to remember is these media controllers have to be in order. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, because it's using this index expression. And for that to work, it's taking the layer of this media controller every time, and it's multiplying it and putting it in its relative location within our carousel. Okay, so now we also have this camera focus. And what this does is it's going to make whatever's in front or closest to the camera in focus. And the way we make that happen is hide any of these media boxes, hit EE. I'm going to grab the Z position. So right click on Z position and do copy expression only. You want to take this distance expression here, go to camera focus, make sure you're 3D, and hit Control V. So now that's linked to our distance up here. And if we highlight camera and camera focus, right click camera, link focus distance to layer. So it's going to be using that distance to determine how the camera is going to be focusing on all of our media boxes. If we click that, we can open up our camera right here under camera options. And I'm just going to kind of crank up this aperture so you can see what it's doing. As we increase it, we can see that this is now the one that's in focus. So open up our spinner again, and let's just take off this time expression. So every time an icon comes to the front, it is now in focus and everything behind it is out of focus. Okay, so now let's kind of play with the settings of this camera control. Hit P, Shift R to bring up our position and rotation, and stop about 1 second here. And let's put a keyframe for position and then one for X rotation. Go back to the beginning and let's kind of push this back a little bit and maybe tilt it down, something like that. And we'll ease this in, put a little bit of speed on this keyframe here. Let's put that time expression back on our spinner here. So alt click rotation, and we'll say time times 100. And if we watch this playback, we can see how everything comes into focus, and you can actually control how this is going to look. You can tilt it any way you want, which is super cool. Gives you a lot of control over this. I'm going to kind of play with this distance because I want you to see how no matter how far away your distance is or how close, it's always going to focus on whatever is in the front, which is super helpful. And it just kind of adds that depth of field. And again, you can control the size of this. That's how you make a media carousel for more than 4 media objects. Again, let's go back up top. As you can see, everything is equal distance apart. As you spread this out, it moves away from the center. The main thing to remember is for this degree setting, you have to divide 360 by however many media objects you have. I hope that helped you out. Please comment, like, share, and subscribe. And click the bell so that way you're notified every time I upload a new video. I'd love to get your feedback about this episode and also hear about any topic you would like to see covered. And sign up for my Udemy course, The Power of Shape Layers. It's a comprehensive course that covers literally every aspect of shape layers, and it's guaranteed to turn you into a shape layer wizard. The link to that course, along with the project file and the notes for this episode and the Shape Layer social media pack, are in the description below. Thanks for watching, everybody. I'll see you next time.